Hello. In this lesson, we're gonna have a, it should be pretty short to summarize on the trig functions about their even odd properties. And we know the function definition as we have repeated over and over, and then we also know the definition of even odd, right? So here the even function, right? Odd function, right? Even function is that for opposite input, they produce the same output. For odd function, is opposite input produces opposite outputs. And for trig functions, of course, we discuss all of these trig functions on the stage set of the three pillars of trigonometry. Angle measurement, right? This is what we have been talking about all the time. The angle measurement, whether those angles are served as input or output, is always measured from the standard position and counterclockwise for positive angle, clockwise for negative angle. Reference angles, right, is a bridge, is a positive acute angle between the terminal and x-axis. And the definition, right? In the previous many lessons, we have discussed about even odd. So here we just merely organize it and summarize it. Okay, we know that R is always a positive, and we know sine is odd function, right? We know sine is odd, cosine is even, tangent is odd. The even odd function can be seen easily from the unit circle. So here I'm going to put something here right next to it to show you how you can tell, right? Sine is odd. From the unit circle, we can tell, right? Because for opposite inputs, the outputs are opposites. Okay, for example, pi over six, right? Negative pi over six. If you look at the blue number, right? The angles are opposite, you know, pi over six, negative pi over six, the blue numbers are opposite. And that is the same for all of those. That's the same for all possible angles, right? Five pi over six, negative five pi over six, right? Five pi over six, right? Negative five pi over six, and the blue numbers are opposite as well. So you can see this is already telling us it's odd, right? So sine is odd. We've seen that when we were graphing, right? On the graph, we saw that the sine curve, by this time we are very familiar with it, right? So sine is odd. So let me sine is odd. Okay. The most obvious place to see sine is odd is if you look at the sine curve. If you look at the sine curve and we graphed it, right? So here we go. For any opposite inputs, we know the inputs for sine are the arc lengths, right? The arc lengths. So for any inputs, these are opposite inputs. And the outputs that are the blue, they're going to be opposite as well. And this is true for any inputs, right? So this demonstrates sine is odd. For cosine. So I like you guys to have these visuals in your thinking process, right? Not only the definition, but also the visual. And on the unit circle part, we just talk about it. And let's look at cosine. Cosine. Okay, cosine, you can see this from the unit circle perspective as well, right? From the unit circle, then if you look at the opposite inputs, right? So any opposite inputs, for example, my input would be measured from standard position, right? Pi over four, negative pi over four. And you look at the red number is the same. The red numbers are sine, right? Sine pi over four and sine negative pi over four, they have the same value. And if you measure three pi over four, negative three pi over four, right? If you measure this is three pi over four, and this is negative three pi over four. If you look at their corresponding red numbers, then they are the same. They're the same. So this tells you that cosine is even function, okay? And of course, from the curve that we graphed, right? From the curve we graphed, and we can see that as well, right? And we definitely have talked about this. And if you like to see more in the content, so here is just a summary. And you can go back to see, to watch those lessons and to see the details, And these properties are rather useful, especially when you are in calculus classes. I would say calc one, calc two, right? So cosine as an odd function. So when the inputs are opposite, right? Inputs, we know they are arc lengths measured from the standard position, right? The arc lengths, right? The golden arc lengths, we've been consistently using that color, the golden arc lengths, the opposite, right? And the output are the same. The outputs are the same. So whenever the inputs are opposite, the output is the same. So cosine is even. Cosine is even. Okay. Now, tangent. 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 Well, tangent is the same thing, right? Tangent is just if you look at from the unit circle, right? If you look at it from the unit circle, right? When the inputs are opposite, okay. When the input are opposite, say I measure an angle that's 2π/3. This is not a proof. This is just verifying. Okay, this is just verifying. A negative 2π/3, right? So this is a positive 2π/3. 2π/3, negative 2π/3, right? They're opposite angles. How about the ratio? Ratio, you take the blue divided by the red, right? Y divided by X, Y divided by X. In this case, you can see the ratio are going to be opposite as well, okay? So this already show us that tangent is odd. Tangent is odd, okay? You can see the blue over red are going to be this opposite ratio as well. And this is true for every possible case, every possible inputs, okay? So that's demonstrate that tangent is odd. Okay, very useful property. So by the time you're doing integration in the calculus classes, you will find it's so convenient to have, if you recognize this property, you can have very, there's a lot of perks that comes with it, okay? The curve also demonstrated that, okay? The curve demonstrated that. So the curve for tangent, of course, we've done this, right? We've done this many times, right? We've done this, the tangent curve. And for opposite inputs, right? So the gold arc lens, for example, for opposite inputs, right? Opposite inputs, negative. And their outputs, okay, so I'm gonna use purple. The outputs are opposite as well. You see the outputs are opposite as well. Okay, so sine is odd, cosine, even, tangent is odd. Then you say, how about the other three? The other three will be very straightforward once we recognize these three functions, right? So now we know sine is odd. All right, so let me make a table, right? Let me make a table for our, let's see. There, just do it for now, okay? So sine is odd. Right, sine is odd, right? Which implies what? What does it imply? Sine is odd implies what? Implies that sine, right? We saw the picture. Sine of any opposite angle is gonna be, the opposite angle produce opposite output, right? Okay, cosine is even. That means for any opposite inputs, okay? And the other one is A, right? Well, they're opposite. I don't need the parentheses here, right? They're output are the same. So cosine negative A is the same as a cosine A. Okay, so that's the algebraic explanation. We just give you the graphic, you know, interpretation, illustration. And algebraically, that's how you write it. Now, of course, this is true for all the possible angles. Tangent is odd. Okay, tangent is odd. Okay, what it implies is a tangent of negative A is the same as negative of tangent A. Then you say, how about the others? How about the other three? For the other three, I'm going to squeeze them in between these current three functions we just talked about. Okay, hold on, I'm gonna put this one over here. And I'm gonna put one, input one row here, there, and one more row beneath tangent, right? Cosecant. If sine is odd, cosecant is odd. Why? Because cosecant is the reciprocal of sine. They're reciprocal to each other. Therefore, cosecant is odd. Okay, cosecant is odd. So cosecant of negative A, of negative angle, is going to go equals to the opposite of cosecant A. Now, secant. Secant is the reciprocal of cosine. Okay, we talk about these in the domain range analysis in the previous summary, right? So secant is even too. Secant is even as well. Okay, so this is a secant. How about the cotangent then? Cotangent is the reciprocal, right? Because one tangent is y over x, cosecant is x over y. So they're reciprocal to each other too. So cotangent is 1 over tangent. And if tangent is odd, cotangent is odd too. So cotangent is odd as well. Whoops. Okay. Cotangent is odd. Cotangent as well. Okay. So these are the summaries of even odd function for the six functions. Then you may say, how about the arcs, right? So this is even, let me write it down, right? This is even. Okay, this is even. And that is odd. Okay, so cotangent is odd. So all of these properties, you can see the similar features. And you can also see it from unit circle. You can also see it from the curve themselves, okay? If we have time, I will squeeze in the graph for secant and cosecant, but not for this week, not for this week. But anyway, so that's even odd properties, and these are the algebraic expressions. These are the algebraic expressions. So odd, right? Even and odd. Okay, then you say, how about for the arc sine, arc cosine, right? And see it for yourself. For example, arc sine. Arc sine. Arc sine, is arc sine even or odd? Is arcsine even or odd? From the curve, right? From the curve and from the process, we can totally analyze, analyze the situation. We can totally analyze the situation. Okay, so here I put the curve there. You can also use the unit circle. Okay, I'm gonna bring the unit circle over here. Right, the unit circle over here. Is it even or odd? Is it even or odd, right? It cannot be even. Why? Because if it's even, it is not a one-to-one, right? But we have a one-to-one function. You know, arc sine is a one-to-one function. It cannot possibly be, it cannot possibly be even, okay? But is it odd? Is it odd? So you basically have to see that for opposite inputs, okay, the opposite inputs, I would say, is it gonna be ratio, right? For opposite inputs, for sine, it's gonna be ratio. For arc sine, right? Arc sine's input are ratio. So the blue and the blue. Okay, we know the domain for arc sine is from negative one to positive one. And the output are the arc length between negative pi over two to positive pi over two. So arc sine is odd. Arc sine is odd, okay? And the other perspective we can see this is that for arc sine, we know that constructing arc sine, we chop off quadrant two and quadrant three. Do we have that odd feature? Right, which is for this time for opposite ratio, do we have opposite angles? Opposite ratio produces opposite angle because arc sine's input are ratios. And the answer is yes, okay? So you can work out the, we did those tables. We did point by point examples, right? So let me show you. So from the picture, you can see that, right? So let me clean this up to show you how the odd function it can be seen from the perspective, right? For example, you just look at a couple of situation here. Okay, we will have, we have arc, we chop off two quadrants. So we only have this quadrant, right? And the ratio would be, say, if I look at the ratio of, hold on, Why do you come here? Okay. Look at the ratio of blue ratios, right? That's a sine ratio. So for root two, over two, that's just an example, okay? This is not a proof. So, and another one for the negative root two over two, So negative root two over two. Right, opposite ratio, opposite inputs for arc sine, okay? And the arc sine of root two over two and arc sine of a negative root two over two, right? We know the former is equals to pi over four. The other one is negative pi over four. So these two are opposite to each other. So this is a negative and they're equal, right? So this basically explained to us that yes, arc sine is odd. If you guys have any questions, feel free to ask me because I didn't go in, I didn't do as many examples. I really just did one example to explain this, okay? Arc cosine. If we remember the curve, right? Let's clean the drawing, okay? Opposite inputs, which are ratios, do they produce opposite angles? That's impossible. Why? Because the output for arc cosine, they're always the output, right? This piece is going to be, the range of arc cosine is between zero to pi. Right? So you're not gonna get a negative. So it's neither even nor odd. So you can tell from the picture. How about arc tangent? How about arc tangent, right? Arc tan, okay? Sometimes seeing from the curve is a bit easier. Arc tan is an odd function. Okay? This is very obviously an odd function. So this is odd. So you just use a definition to determine whether it is even or odd. Arc cotangent, no, it cannot be, right? Because arc cotangent, is the range is between zero to pi, right? And arc cotangent is neither. Arc cotangent, the range is from zero to pi. Okay, so it's neither even nor odd. And you can tell from that picture. So I know this software doesn't graph arc cotangent, and I'm not gonna graph it using the other software. You guys can just go ahead and practice. Okay, go ahead, practice. For secant, cosecant, we know they're even, we know secant is even, cosecant is odd. We're not gonna cover about arc secant, arc cosecant. They're rarely used. And so for now, if you can just understand everything we have covered so far and really, really understand them and I know how to apply them, and that will be amazing already, okay? So, that's all for this lesson. It's fairly short. We did some examples, but if you have any questions, please don't hesitate to reach out to me. Thank you for watching.